Hi guys, Golden Tails Geek here, and welcome to another Redux video for my Let's Play of Wario Land 2. In the last episode, my buddy Johnny Stallard Games joined me for the first couple levels of the Mysterious Factory chapter, and for the next couple levels, another friend is joining me, and she also knows Johnny. Introduce yourself.
Hey guys, this is Sam, also known as Mario Fangirl 93 and Rock Music Level 93 on YouTube, but Mario Fangirl 93 is my channel just for gaming and other gaming related stuff or reaction sometimes reactions or do bowling videos in the future, but
Yeah, I've been wanting to get Sam on my channel for some time. It just happened to coalesce today when we both had a day off, so it just it
yes,
it's a good.
because since today is Columbus Day, so I just
Well, I prefer to
figured
call
I'd
it
just
Indigenous Peoples Day, but to each their own.
yeah because they let me get a day off on on Columbus Day,
Yeah, they
so
let me
I
get a day
just
off on my job too. I was really happy about that. So,
well, I'm happy for that, Kevin.
yeah, me too. Anywho, let's get started on these levels here. Now we're gonna start moving through some water. Can you hear the game okay?
Yes, I can hear it.
Okay,
Thanks.
cool. Because, yeah, I've had.
I really have to get into Wario Land games because I think I have played a single Wario Land game before, because there's once that I that was during my elementary school years, when I was in fifth grade, that they have a Game Boy Color
Oh yeah.
of it, and each classmate takes turns for which what game they want to play. So I
That's
tried
cool.
Wario Land and I actually liked it.
Yeah, I love the Wario Land games. I mean, when the first game came out on the original Game Boy, it was kind of like a self-satire, a self-parody of sorts of standard Mario platformers. But like from this one onwards, it's more like a puzzle platformer, really, where you just explore every nook and cranny,
Oh
trying to
yeah.
solve puzzles and everything. And it's really inventive, actually. I find I love the Wario Land games. Although, granted,
Yeah.
but hang on, I kind of messed up something there. Oh well. Well,
It
a little
no
shortcut there.
problem, because I've seen your other
Yeah.
episodes and
Yeah.
I actually find it entertaining.
Oh yeah, the Wario Land series is tremendously irreverent. I mean, I'm not entirely sure if I want to, if I ever get a capture device, if I'll ever do Wario Land Shake It for the Wii. But even though I do like it, from what I've played of it so far, I haven't really beaten it 100% yet. But but I just don't know if it would be like I don't know if I could do it. So, I mean, I
Yeah.
love Wario, don't get me wrong, and I love the art style of it, especially with the little anime-esque cutscenes. But
Oh
it's
yeah, same here. I actually like the art style of
and the music is awesome
that,
too. I mean, especially the music on the
especially
main
since
menu.
the
It's
music.
just so good. So
And
Wario.
oh yeah, the music definitely kicks ass.
Yeah, it's a shame they never really did official soundtrack releases for some of these games. I mean, it's just I feel like some of this music is just underrated, I guess was the right word I'm thinking of. Yeah, I mean, heck, even some of I mean, just using some of this music for Smash Brothers would be kind of cool instead of having WarioWare tunes
Oh
all the time.
yeah,
I mean, don't
Smash.
get me wrong, I like some of the tunes in the WarioWare games too, like Ashley's theme, but sometimes or even for that robot with the microphone who loves karaoke, Although
Definitely.
speaking of him, I actually kind of find it hilarious that Dr. Krygor created him a karaoke robot basically to help with house cleaning, and I'm just like, well, and then he gets all surprised when he turns out he gets the urge to do karaoke, and I'm like, hello. I mean, for how clever Dr. Krygor is, he just I don't know, he seems kind of like a ditz. At least how he's
Yeah.
depicted in the WarioWare Gold, but because I have it on
Oh, yeah.
3DS, I have that game on 3DS, and it's so good. And all the
I
characters,
unfortunately haven't played a single WarioWare games, but
they're fun,
I
actually.
think you
They're
should.
you got to really think on your feet for them a lot of the time, but they're fun. Hang on, I'm gonna turn off the thing where we're gonna check something.
Yeah, there you
Ah,
go.
yep. Okay, yep.
That way it'll be easier.
Yeah, that way I can actually get in here and grab those coins. All right, now I'm gonna flip the switch. I remember this level kind of surprising me a bit because you could actually see like the switch actually having an effect on screen as opposed to just it, not only it's just changing the blocks like this, but also just, you know, seeing the sync turn on and off. I thought that was really cool.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. And just the details and the sprite work and everything in this game for such a handheld, they're so good. I mean, the first three Wario Lands are actually on 3DS Virtual Console, but pretty cheap if you want to give them a try, actually, Sam.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know about it, so.
And I believe Wario Land 4 is on Wii U, so. You know, because I still have a Game Boy Advance and Game Boy Advance SP, and
I have my SP collecting dust somewhere in my room, so I understand.
You know, if I can do LPs in the future with for Game Boy or Game Boy Advance, I have the GameCube, but I think I should use the Game Boy Player for that.
Yeah, I'd probably do the same thing if I was in your situation, but resources prevent me from having that luxury, so that's why I mostly use, you know, Visual Boy Advance and Camtasia. Don't sue me, Nintendo. Ah, no! Ah, I hate those spikes.
Shit, it's what I
they
send
me flying.
That.
Yeah. Oh well. Yeah, I forgot those spikes were up there. Otherwise, I would have been a little more careful. All right, let's grab those. Grab those. I'm gonna grab those coins right there. And then I'm gonna grab those coins because I like to grab as many coins as I can when it comes to these games. Oh, hang on, before I do anything, I'm just gonna let the bouncing wear out on its own here.
Oh yeah.
There we go. Cool. And bunk.
Oh.
All right. Good riddance. Let's head over here. I'm trying to remember where everything is because I haven't played these levels in like ages.
So I know it's been like so when is the last time you played this level?
Probably since I think when I recorded the LP actually, so that was about 6 years ago. Because I haven't really touched a lot of the games I've played for my old projects. Link's Awakening being the sole exception because the remake came out for the Switch recently. Well, I said recently, but more like a month ago. But still. Okay. I'm trying to remember how I'm supposed to get down there.
Yeah, I was just wondering how the fuck can you go through is to get all these coins?
Oh, here's the door. Okay, cool. I found the door. Okay, there we go. Oh, yeah. I don't know if you saw, but it went from 311 to 313. That's a weird glitch. There's a weird glitch. It's a weird glitch that happens. In fact, there's certain coins that can give you 100 coins that pop up from time to time, and actually, sometimes there's a chance that it could give you 200 coins if it falls into the water. So, and that was a glitch that was actually in the original Game Boy version of the game. And they actually—oh darn it! I don't want to go there just yet and get to the goal. But for some reason they didn't correct it in the original in this Game Boy Color version because the But then again, the Game Boy version of this game actually is a rare instance where it didn't come out in Japan. It only came out in the States and for some reason. At least that's what I read.
Yeah.
I've been doing a little more research on this game lately just to kind of make things a little more informative in these Redux videos than I was back when I first made these videos, because I was kind of in a bad place in my life when I recorded the old versions of these videos, because I was dealing with a friend of mine who suddenly passed away, but
seems like it's difficult.
Oh, yeah.
And it takes some time to you know, like, how do we pass that, and how do we go through this? Oh, there you go. Now,
there's elements of puzzle solving, so, and that's certain locks you gotta destroy with like enemies or whatever, so. And I don't mind that, actually. I think it's kind of nice, because it's just it shakes things up from what could have been just a conventional platformer. So anyway, I'm going to leap up here, and now I'm just going to keep having Wario run back and forth here. That's those. There's the goal, but we don't want to go there just yet, so.
Yeah, we can't go to the goal just yet, because there's
Still a little bit left of the level to explore now that I've hit that switch. Okay, there we go. Cool. Oh, no you don't. No you don't. Alright. Now I'm just gonna head down here. Grab these coins. There we go. Cool. And boom. Alright. Now we've got all those coins, I'm going to head back down here real quick, and I'm going to... Save my game here, because in the style of my old video, versions of this, these videos, I didn't know about save states back then, so I would save my game. So I'm just trying to keep it in that same style as when I recorded it. Granted, that kind of backfired on me a little bit when I was recording with Johnny, but you know... Thankfully,
although I haven't seen this part, but I think I gotta rewatch it again.
Yeah.
Because if I think I had to watch it when I had the chance, because I was super busy with stuff. That's why I haven't got a chance to look at your episodes. I've only watched
totally
a little
bit of it. And the reason I'm saving before doing that is because this little door here, if you go into it, it's the treasure room. So
that's why you saved it.
Yeah, because that way I don't lose a lot of coins, because I like to play on the hard difficulty for these, because it's only 50 coins. Anyway, I gotta be quiet here and see which one it is. Okay. I think it's this one. Yes! Got it!
Nice.
Gotta match it, and you get the treasure, and that's one step closer to 100% completion. Ooh, it's an hourglass. I kind of forgot that. Yeah. And then we're going to head back to the goal, and then... there we go. And then body slam that guy.
Can't believe Wario Land game came out over 20 years now.
But the fact that it still holds up is a testament to Nintendo's gameplay. So that game stuff. Now, again, in the style of my older Let's Plays, I'm going to save my game here before I enter the goal, because at the end of every level, there's a little lovely little game that we have to play in order to get a picture panel for another step towards 100% completion. So I want to make sure I get that. All right. That's a lot of coins.
Basically,
it's like all these panels flip closed, and then it counts down from three. And then the panel, every 50 coins are taken away from you, and you gotta match the number. So let's see here. I'm gonna say it's 8. All right.
Yep, you got it.
Spot on.
You're right.
Yeah. There were a few times actually in my early videos there I actually somehow managed to get it right by just seeing one panel. It was so weird.
Yeah.
And I was like, how did I do that?
This seems not so hard this part, because if I looked at it, it looks like it's 8, but you got it.
Yeah. And now we're gonna be heading to one of the more kind of tedious levels, Don't Shock the Owl.
Oh, Don't Shock the Owl.
Well, yeah, it's called that because of these little blocks here that can shock you, and you have to actually ride on these owls here through the stage and explore. You have to be really careful.
And that is, that level makes sense.
Yeah. Some of these titles for some of these levels, it's just like, what the hell? But, you know, it's fun. It's fun. Grab these. Oh, easy. There we go. Slow and steady wins the race. Still, really impressive sprite work. In fact, I vaguely remember in the original Game Boy version, like, that it looked like Wario was wearing fingerless gloves a little bit, and some of these sprites too.
I know it looks awkward like this, but it is Wario in gloves. But this is how the game looks.
Yeah. Okay. I love the graphical style in this game. I think it holds up amazingly.
Yeah, to be honest, people cared about graphics, like, you know, these
This is one guy I follow on YouTube and stuff lately who, like, he did a game series, a video series on, like, games and gamer culture and stuff, and he said, you know, back in my day of gaming, we used to argue about which mascot was cooler, like Mario versus Sonic, and nowadays, and it's just gotten sad now because it's like everyone's arguing over consoles. Like, it's like, you gotta, like, oh, this one has better hardware specs than this one, and it's just sad. I mean, just.
I know, it is.
Especially considering that a lot of consoles nowadays are just as good, if not better, are just as good as maybe a really fine tuned gaming PC, you know? Or some cases, inferior to a gaming PC, but, yeah. But anyway, toss. Oh, I missed my shot there. There we go.
There you go.
Yeah. And toss. There we go. I love exploring every nook and cranny in these levels because just you're always rewarded for with a lot of coins for it. Let's see here. I'm gonna head back this way. See what I can find. Carefully. Careful. Splendid. Ooh, hang on. There's some coins up here. I want to get these. I always try to get every single coin I can in these levels, which is why it takes so long to which is why I limited myself to only two levels per video when I recorded this LP back in the day. Good grief. anyway. Okay. Back up we go.
Yep. One back up.
Moving on up. There we go.
There we go.
I actually kind of like the little arrows on the background. There,
oh, there's a bubble.
Too. Oh, yeah. You gotta get in the bubbles to get past those little rapid things.
Yeah.
And Mario's like, I'm in bubble. Help me.
this is actually funny.
Yeah,
you know,
that's what I love about Wario
looks
is just his facial expressions.
Inside the bubble.
Yeah. That's what I love about these games, too, is just the facial expressions and stuff. In fact, Wario even kind of calls attention to it in the manual for the fourth game, where he's like, if you're a toolbox...
With Wario's look, especially since...
I love
Wario. Part when it comes to Wario, like, is, with his ass, can't, like that, I don't know, what was your thoughts on that?
I thought it was funny, but, yeah. Although,
yeah, it's funny as well, yeah.
Yeah, it's very irreverent, this series, but that's why I like it. But it's kind of strategic in its bad taste in some cases, I think. Although in some cases I think that the Earthworm Jim games, as much as I love them, kind of went a little too overboard with it. Well, that doesn't help that Doug Tenapel, the person who created the series, is a bigoted jerk, from what I've heard. I've actually seen some of his...
I'll be right back.
Yep. Do you want me to pause the game until your turn, or no?
You can go ahead.
All right. Sam will be back in a moment, folks, so it'll just be me for a moment. Let's resume.
Continue.
Okay, folks, we're back. Sam had to go take care of something, but, you know, she's back now, and that's what matters. Yay! Anyway, let's...
Yeah, that didn't take that long.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, this is one of my favorite enemies, as annoying as he is, because, you know, it almost looks like he had like two little plugs on his head, like devil horns. It's kind of adorable in a creepy sort of way. I can't remember what they're called, but, you know, they're pretty cool looking. That's another thing I love about the games, is just the enemy designs are just so outrageous. Granted, they're not quite as outrageous as, say, the Dragon Quest monsters. I mean, Akira Toriyama says hi, but, you know. I mean, of course, I say that because I've been playing a lot of Dragon Quest XI on my Switch lately, so... And there's some enemies that I've been familiar with.
There's definitely going to be more Dragon Quest games in the future.
Yeah. Well, I mean, the series has been around for 30 years, so I would hope so. I mean, they recently released, like, remastered versions of sorts of the first three games onto the Switch that are more based off of the mobile phone ports of the games, but still, pretty cool nevertheless. But, yeah, I kind of got into Dragon Quest pretty late, honestly. I mean, I didn't get into it until, like not long after I was graduating high school. It was around the time the eighth game in the series was coming out on PS2, and my brother had pre-ordered it, and at the time, he had just gotten out of a bad relationship with someone really terrible, and he basically kind of just spent the break... He basically dealt with the breakup by way of basically sipping a little whiskey now and then, and also playing Dragon Quest VIII. So, you know. I mean, aside from the whiskey, it seems like a pretty healthy way to deal with a breakup, but, you know. Thankfully, he doesn't, like, drink himself into a stupor like he used to, because his wife won't have it. Because, you know, she doesn't want... You know, he used to be really bad about that, but thankfully he's kind of cleaned up a bit since then, so...
Yeah.
Alright. But, yeah, I do love my brother. He's a really wonderful guy, so... Even if he does have his issues now and then. So... Anyway, let's head over here. Ah, this one room. Okay, cool.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, you. There we go.
Yep.
And Fat Wario can just break through these things. And
yep. Now Wario is a fat ass.
Well, he already was, but this makes it a little more evident.
Yep, but that's...
Not that I'm fat shaming, mind you, folks.
But the problem is, you know, you can't get through it when it's too big.
Yeah. Not that I want people to think I'm fat-shaming, by the way. I mean, I understand weight loss is a very complicated thing to deal with. I mean, even though I'm skinny as a rake sometimes. Well, thin as a rake, rather. But regardless, but still.
That's the only problem with, you know, little small spaces there, but you only do just, you just pound it like this.
So, there we go. Awesome. There we go. The diet plan, it sort of works. Oops.
Yep.
Darn it, I was trying to get up there so I could, there we go. There we go. Now I just gotta get those two little coins. There we go. Cool. Alright. Gotta love those little chef enemies.
Right. Oh, yeah.
Let's drop down here some. Get these coins over here.
Down here.
Every nook and cranny. And I've already been in this area. Okay, cool. God, I've already gotten like 600 coins. Oh, man.
Just looking at it, close to 700 coins.
Yeah, the coins really add up in this game if you really explore every little facet of every level. So, and I like to do that because, you know, you kind of need coins if you expect to get all the treasures and the picture panels and whatnot. So, I already went in that door. So, let's head back up here. Easy does it. Down we go. Okay. It's like a maze, I swear. Alrighty. Boom.
There you go.
Yep. Oh, and there's the exit, but we don't want to go there just
yet.
Yep,
there we go.
I don't want to go there just yet, though. There we go. Okay.
Yeah.
Break those blocks, grab those. Grab that. Oop. Come on. There we go.
Four coins.
Oop. Come on. Oop. Are you kidding me? There we go. Cool. Break that. Break that. Grab those. All right. Oh, that's the thing about enemies. You leave them sit and they disappear like that. And I need them to get these blocks here so I can get those... get those coins up there. Okay. Grab that. Cool. I hate those little spike things. They're such a tedious little obstacle. Oh, crap. Oh, well... I should have just tossed upwards.
Oh. Yeah.
Alright. Maybe I won't be able to get those coins. Ah, well. That, I mean, it's not a big deal, but at the same time, it kind of is. I guess.
No, it isn't.
I mean, or maybe... Wait, I got an idea here. There we go. I think I got one of them. There we go! Got him!
That works. There you go.
I love doing that. Okay. Okay, break that block. Back block. And just... There. Good. Now, let's see. Head over here, and I'm gonna save my game again, because that's the treasure room, so...
Yeah.
Okay. Alright. Coins, it'll go fast, so I gotta pay attention here. Keep an eye for that one-eyed jack there. Oh! Same place as the other guy! How about that?
Yeah.
That is spooky how that works. I've never had that happen before. Oh, I can't tell what that treasure is. Let me check that real quick. Huh. If I didn't know any better, I'd say that looks like a Metroid, actually.
I thought it looked like... That's what looked like it's a Metroid or something.
Yeah, it does kind of look like a Metroid. Familiar. At least to me it does.
Yeah. Same here.
Yeah. When I first saw that thing, when I played the original Game Boy version, I didn't know what Metroid was, so I thought it was a weird old little brain in a jar thing that, you know, that... And I was like, how did they get that past the sensors?
Then until, like, with protagonist Samus, a lot of people thought Samus was a dude, but it's actually a woman.
Yeah.
Just because the character is, like, 6'3", which is, you know, normal for a man. But there's not too many women were that tall, but it's the character itself.
Yeah, I mean, I'm 6'1", so I can't, and when I'm in my sneakers, so I can't really comment on that front. Although I remember seeing on Twitter that Brie Larson, who plays Captain Marvel, expressed an interest in playing Samus, and I was like, you know, for my dream casting for a while was Claudia Black, but if you want to give it a go, I'm okay with that. So, anyway... Let's do the puzzle for this game, and then we'll call it an episode here.
Yeah. You know, I actually like this level. You know,
This is actually pretty interesting. It's very intricate, but also very nice. Anyway, let's see if we can figure out what number this is. I think it's a 6, but I'm not sure. If I'm wrong, I'll reset the game.
Problem, I guess, is a 6 or a 5.
Probably. Oh, it's a 6.
There you go. You're right. It's 6.
Yeah, my brain just is really sharp today, I guess. I'm on fire!
You totally are.
Indeed. And with that, the game is saving. And I'm going to load up the last level here, awaiting syrup. And we're going to call it an episode, so next time on my Redux videos of Wario Land 2, we'll do this level, and I'll have another co-commentator joining me. Thank you for joining me, Sam. It's been a real blast.
Oh, you're welcome, Kevin. Thank you for having me here.
And I'll put a link in the description so you can check out Sam's stuff. You know, she's really great. I mean, she's just a really great, got a great bubbly personality, and it's just, I love talking to her.
Oh, thanks. Well, you know, I have some issues with my upcoming videos, and I was just so flustered when I just try to edit it out.
Yeah.
It's like, it's really fucking frustrating.
I understand. We all have our hang-ups when it comes to recording stuff, but hey, hopefully you'll get them smoothed out, and then things will get better. So, anyway.
Oh, yeah.
Until the next one, this has been Golden Tales Geek, and that's been Sam, aka Mario Fangirl 98, and... Just 93, sorry. I knew it was a 90-something. Well, thanks for watching. Keep on gaming and be awesome to one another. See ya!
This is Mari Fangirly Grease signing out.
Well said.